Hey, what's going on everybody? It's Mike again. In this video, I'm going to give you guys my recommendations on headphones and audio products that I like to use while traveling. Some of you may be traveling to see friends and family during this holiday season, so I hope this video will help you make an informed decision on what to buy or what to bring with you on the trip. As you can see here, I have quite a few products. I'm going to go through each one of them in no particular order and let you guys know my opinion on it and why I recommend it. So let's not waste any time. Let's get right into it. Okay, so we're going to look at a headphone that's actually an in-ear headphone. It's from Edemonic. If you guys don't know Edemonic, they make very high quality in-ear monitors. These are Balance Armature. They also make hearing aids or earplugs to protect your hearing. These are the ER4PT. There are several versions of this. The PT version comes with an adapter which changes the impedance of the headphones to the ER4S, which is a reference class headphone, in my opinion. So when you buy the PT, you basically get two headphones for the price of one. The ER4PT, it's a very neutral headphone. In my opinion, these are probably the in-ear version of the Sennheiser HD800. They're that revealing, that accurate. Now, the downside to these headphones is that you have to jam it in your ears quite deep, very far into your ears to get the best sound quality from it. So if you're not comfortable with that, then these may not be for you. But if you are comfortable with it, the results are phenomenal, and I think that you cannot buy a more accurate and more revealing in-ear headphone under $1,000. These sell for $299. So it's a phenomenal price, the fact that you get the sound quality of two headphones with this. Comes with a variety of ear tips. They do not have an iOS remote. These are purely for music listening. And Edemonic does make a similar version with the iOS remote. I believe those are called HF3. Those are about $150. But not as revealing as the ER4s. So if you're looking for a very accurate in-ear headphone, you want a taste of what the flagship Sennheiser HD800 sounds like, without breaking the bank, the HD800 is $1,500. These will give you 90% of that, maybe even more than 90%, but if you are comfortable with jamming them in far into your ears, these headphones will give you very, very good sound quality, and perhaps one of the best in-ear headphones I've used. Highly recommend it. Check it out. Edemonic ER4PT. You will not be disappointed. All right, everyone, let's look at another pair of headphones. All right, so guys, it's no secret, looking at the videos in my channel, that I am a fan of Beats headphones and their products. These are the new Beats Studio, phenomenal headphones. I really think that Beats did a great job redesigning the studio. The original studio looks really good. However, these new studio, in my opinion, looks sexy. It's hard to say that about a headphone, but, these are really, really, to me, just oozes sex appeal. Build quality is very strong. These are well-built headphones. Fit and finish is phenomenal. Materials used is also very high quality, definitely improved from its previous generation. In fact, all the new Beats products have improved a lot in terms of build quality and sound quality. I remember the Solo HD, the original Solo HD, was kind of boomy and muddy and muffled sounding. the new Solo HD, the Drenched in Color Solo HD, it's very, very good. Very clean, very punchy bass. I think that you'll be impressed by them, and with all the new Beats products, actually. I think that secretly Beats must have done something under the hood of their headphones, because the current generation of Beats headphones are much better sounding than the previous ones. The studio is perhaps my favorite because of the styling and the sound quality. It does have active noise canceling, so it does block out outside noise very well. It uses an internal amplifier and also an internal noise canceling circuitry. There's a battery fuse gauge right here to let you know how much battery is left in the headphones. So you no longer have to put in AA batteries. The battery is built inside the headphone. Fit and finish is very good, nicely weighted. And styling is superb, in my opinion. These are the best looking headphones on the planet, hands down. Now, you can get it in a variety of colors. You can even get the new Studio here in a wireless version. I like that it folds into a compact package. It comes with a carrying case as well as a hard shell case. It comes with an iOS remote control cable and also a straight audio cable. Comes with a charger to charge the batteries. The internal battery lasts about 20 hours, so it's quite good. One thing I wish that it had was a passive mode, so when the batteries are dead, you can still use it. It doesn't have that, so I hope Beats will change that or update that in a future release of the new Studio. Other than that, these headphones are phenomenal, great sound. It's no longer for rap music people. These are great sounding headphones for all type of music now. Still not an audiophile great, but certainly much improved from the previous generation. So I urge you to go check these out. You'll be impressed, and I think that you'll be impressed by the other Beats headphones, the Solo HD as well. So everyone, let's look at another pair of headphones. Alright, so the last headphone that we're going to look at is perhaps my favorite. These are the Bang & Olufsen H6. They sell for $399 here in the US. So $400, but I think that these are well worth every penny. These are over-the-ear design, very premium quality. It's all aluminum here, genuine leather, good padding on the headband, very lightweight, genuine sheepskin leather with memory foam ear pads. Every bit of this headphone oozes premium quality, very well made, real solid. Super comfortable. You put them on, you can just wear them for all day and not feel any discomfort. They seal really well, so because these are memory foam, so the passive noise isolation is very good. You can plug in the cable on either side of the ear cup, so depending on if you're left or right-handed. It does come with an iOS remote cable. So you can use it with your Apple device. Sound quality, audiophile grade, certainly very revealing, very transparent. Just the right amount of bass to keep things interesting, not overwhelming at all, very clean. I really enjoy these headphones. I certainly like these more than I like the B&W P7. The B&W P7 is not in this review because they are a lot more bulky than the headphones that I've used, that I showed you guys. So I wouldn't travel with them. In the carrying case on the P7 is actually cumbersome to use. The Bang & Olufsen H6 here falls flat like this for easy travel. It does not come with a hard shell case. I wish it did, because these headphones should be protected in a hard shell case, because these are very nice. It does come with a carrying pouch though, so it does protect it from scratches. Drive it right off your iDevice, your iPod or iPhone. These will give you audiophile grade sound, and highly recommend. You really have to hear these in your own listening environment. A store demo at the Apple Store really doesn't do it justice. The better the source material, actually, the better these will sound, of course. These are very transparent headphones. Great headphone. In fact, I like these so much, I called up Jude, founder of Headfi.org. I told him, you know, you got to check these headphones out. You know, I think that you'll like them a lot, and you may put them in the winter gift guide. So I hope he likes it as much as I like it, because I certainly think that more people should know more about Bang & Olufsen and the H6 headphones. So everyone, that's it for my recommendations for a travel headphone. Now we'll look at some sources. So stay tuned. Don't go anywhere.